in the environment that we live in, you know, it's very, very hard to come up with somebody that is known as an artiste manager, per se. Somebody who says, I manage an artiste, has the interest of the artiste 100%. The thing that you are interested in is the performance of the artiste. So let me take acting, for example. If as an actor, this manager will be looking for roles. He's looking for, but who's now shooting a new comedy or shooting a new drama? Is Shelley Frimpomas who's doing a new film? Is KSM about to do a new play? Is Ibuhuay doing this? All sorts of things, you know. You want to be abreast of what is going on. Why? Just so you can get a platform for your client to perform on. You know, so your client could be sitting at home and I give them a call. Hey, Abna, listen, Ebo White is doing a film production. I want you to go on audition. I'm setting it up for you. Oh, really? When? And then I give you all the information. You know? Meanwhile, I've sent Ebo White some profile of you and why I'm sending you. So that's the role of a manager. They hustle. They make sure that they keep you busy. So what I said before, in what I wrote was that, number one, our industry has not developed to that stage yet where there are like hundreds of films being produced, so the manager is busy hustling up and down and all of that, you know. When you have that kind of environment, then you need a manager because it is their duty to do the research for you. It is their duty to place you. It is their duty to find you gigs. And when they find all of that, they negotiate the fee for you. Then they take their cut. But you realize that they found you the gig, they did all the research. Sometimes for acting performances, they sent you to the audition. All of that, then they take their cut. So for me, it was very funny when I called somebody and said, oh, KSM, okay, so-and-so represented me, talk to my manager. Oh, really? You know? And when I called the manager, I don't want to mention names, the first thing, oh, hey, what's it, how much? And it took me aback because if I'm managing you, the first thing I want to know is what script kind of script is it? I want to see the script. I want to read the script and say, oh, this part, dear, I need it for you. Why? Because the last script you played a different character than this one. I want you to expand in your horizon. Or the last one you played was a tragedy. Now I want to play in the comedy. Or whether you played the comedy, I want to play. You know, there are all kinds of things that you look out for your artist to help them grow professionally. You know, so in the absence of that, if all you do is, you don't even bring me the artist. I find the artist, and I want to use with them. I want to use them. And then you say, how much? Oh, you're not representing the artist. You know, so that's what I meant by, fine, I can understand that our industry is not grown to that level. So let us accept them for who they are. They are just the fee collectors. If I want to book you, I'll have to pay a fee to this one. I was writing some articles on some great, great, great artists in this country. And I called one manager, and I said, send me a soft copy. I want some bio, something about how they rehearse, something about how they work, something about their commitment and things that, I want something that's not on Google, something I can get from the manager who knows, you know, how he started up to now. But if you go to him, also a manager, and it's, the first thing will be how much, you know. So that's what I'm talking about, you know, that we don't have that level of management. Maybe we do in some of the areas, you know, so I won't generalize, but I'm saying for the most part in acting and in music, I don't see that level of management that I'm talking about.